One of the hardest things to do in any sport is win a championship. Even more difficult, do it two times in a row. And tonight, that's what was on the mind of CVU. Welcome into the NBC5 Sports Desk. I'm Noah Searson. Red Hawks girls basketball lost four starters coming into this season, yet still earned the one seed in Division I. Only team they lost to in the regular season, St. Johnsbury, who they match up against tonight at Patrick Gymnasium. Early on, it was all Hilltoppers. Cassidy Kittredge in the corner, catch and shoot, and she drains it. St. J goes on an 8-1 run to start the game, punctuated by this right here. Kaya Anderson, end of the shot clock, finds Hayden Wilkins, a 35-foot bomb. At the end of the first quarter, CVU only 3 points in the first 8 minutes. St. J up 6 at half. Second half, senior Elise Berger chipping away with her jumper. Still down 6. Now it's tied. Berger takes it to the rack and finishes. That one gives them the lead. She had the team-high 10 points, and this was the big play. 40 seconds left, CVU up. Berger finds Samar Ashu off the perfect inbounds play, and CVU celebrating again after a 38-33 win. Berger and Ashu a part of the team that's now won back-to-back titles.
I guess something really amazing about our team is that we are a true team. Every single person comes into the gym, works hard, and you saw that in that second half. We didn't give up. Every single person put in that effort, and every single person contributed to that second half.
I think after that loss early in the season, we knew like we needed that. I think coming into the playoffs undefeated is really hard, and just knowing that there is a team out there that can beat us just motivated us to like be better, motivated us to work harder in the gym almost every single day.
Two more tickets to championships punched in Barry. Today, West Rutland takes down Arlington by 46. Golden Horde going to take on Long Trail on Saturday. And Fairhaven wins a defensive battle 36-28. Slater's going to be taking on Sabine Bruick in North Country this week.